Hello viewers, I'm Red2006 and I'm very pleased to have you join me on the latest leg of our scenic tour through the Johto region in Pokemon Gold version. As a quick recap on our last day's adventuring,
the site trip to go fishing yielded some pretty good catches in the form of Shellder, Corsola, Chinchou and Staryu. Then I took on the Olivine City Gym and Jasmine caught me by surprise. Once I'd recovered from that, I headed in to Mount Mortar and Route 42. We restart the action there. You know, sometimes it's really good just being able to relax. It's nice to have you with me, it's nice to be able to tour the region, but sometimes you just gotta kick back and enjoy the scenery in the peaceful mountains. Plenty of lovely mountain lakes, there'd be fresh air, and a lot of trainers to battle. That's what we're doing today, so let's get rolling. Our first opponent right here. And he's yelling at us despite the fact there is a fat guy clearly standing nearby. Well, he's a jerk. And he's gonna get what he deserves at the hands of torture. Now we are dealing with lower level Pokemon again due to the fact you can go in either direction when you get to Ecruteak City. It's a bit bothersome. It's the one thing I'd fix about the remakes, the iffy level curve. Well, I'll admit there are two things I'd fix about the remakes. The accessibility of Johto Pokemon is the other thing. I still believe that if you did tweak those things in a remake, kept everything that Heart Gold and Soul Silver did, and polished the level curve and made some of the Johto Pokemon A, more accessible, and B, hopefully a bit better, you'd pretty much have a perfect Pokemon game on your hands. As a result, I find it very, very disappointing that a lot of the things Heart Gold and Soul Silver brought up, a lot of the bonds between people and Pokemon that appear in that game, were ignored in order to make the plot of Black and White work. Because if you did bring those things up, if you did bring up all the bonds people have with their Pokemon and the like, then Team Plasma's position would have been utterly flattened in about 5 seconds. They'd have had nothing. Instead, we don't actually get the matter actually addressed. It's sort of, oh hey, you guys are wrong because your boss is a hypocrite. So this is a fisherman rambling over. I think best bet will be Dash. Depends on what he has though. I'll have to get Merzig out because there is another fisherman we can battle. Please don't tell me it's a Magikarp. Fisher Chris has Quillfish. Okay, we still haven't caught Quillfish. Ralph is dropping the ball and I think I have to give him a rematch. Probably could take care of some of these with torture, but I'm not really confident. Not going to be very confident until he evolves. And Chris is defeated. I will switch to Ruby because our next opponent is a hiker. And Ruby had a bad time against Jasmine, so she needs a bit of a moment in the limelight. Okay, Diglett. We should be able to deal with that fairly easily. Surprised we're actually faster, but then again we are double its level plus one. Then again, Diglett does have reasonable speed, so who knows? Dugtrio? Maybe. Maybe faster. Yep. Oh, magnitude 9? I mean, it's not going to do heaps and heaps of damage, but it's the principle of the whole thing. Well, thankfully, Ruby answered with a pretty good magnitude of her own. If I got something like 4 or 5, that would have been really dodgy. And Geodude, we're definitely faster than that. And there we go, taken care of very easily. So, with that done, let's go and get Mersey from the Pokemon Center in Mahogany Town. There is the gym, with a random fat guy standing in front of it. What does he have to say? Well, we do have to head to the Lake of Rage. So let's heal the team and grab Mersey back. There should be plenty to do up at the Lake of Rage and a few hidden paths as well. We do need Bellsprout, but I'm not going to worry too much about those paths just yet. In fact, I might actually switch out one of the team members. I'll keep hold of Bellsprout so I can go and grab some items. Let's see, we will switch out... Leon can take a break because he generally overpowers everything in his path. And we will put Mersey back in the party. And we have a call from Chad. What's he got to say? Okay, Snubbull. We've got half an hour to get those, so let's head on back. Sorry, Lake of Rage, but this takes priority. Okay, something else I'm wondering about. Let me check my Pokedex. So we can see Suicune there. Where is it at the moment? Okay, so it's on Route 36. I will occasionally keep track of Suicune. Hopefully I do get a shot at catching it, but if I don't, that's okay too. So let's go. We can find Goldeen around these parts. And maybe I've run into one. Yep, I have. So I should probably switch to Torchic for this one. Torchic will be my best bet at catching most things. Okay, Supersonic misses. Quick Attack is the go. Okay, let's try. I think I should buy some more Great Balls, not only for what's coming up at the Lake of Rage, but for Snubbull. Nope, might need to put this one to sleep. It's a bit circuitous, but it works in the long run, I think. There we go. Let's grab it. That's a bit of a surprise. And I can't really do much more chip damage. And I am not wasting my Ultra Ball on it, I'll tell you that much. There we are. Goldeen, the goldfish Pokemon. Its dorsal, pectoral, and tail fins wave elegantly in water. That is why it is known as the Water Dancer. It's not a particularly remarkable Pokemon. Useful to have around, but not particularly remarkable. Only really notable for the fact it learned an HM move naturally. Okay, so we don't have another fisherman there. I think one of them got moved around. A lot of my memories do come from the remakes, so I apologize if I stuff things up. So we'll stop off at the Mart in Ecruteague City, and I shall buy some more Great Balls. Ten will do the trick. We'll be pretty well stocked, and I think I should sell a few things. Let's see, what can I sell? Just to clear out Burn Heal, I'm probably not going to need. And I have full heals to take care of that. Moo Moo Milk, very useful. Super Repel, Guard Spec, I can sell that. Wait. Did I have another one or something? Or I just pressed the wrong button? There we go. Alright, off we go to try and find Snubbull. And I'll switch Torture to the head of the party, just to make things a bit easier. Of course, he might still knock them out, I'm not sure. I probably should use the bicycle too. So here we are, and hopefully we find Snubbull. First one. Alright, Torture, let's go. Rightio, I should be able to switch to Sunny for this one. I probably do need to try and catch Scyther at some point. That way I have a Pokemon with False Swipe, which will be very handy. Once it becomes a TM, it is much, much better to have a Parasect on your team, because it can learn False Swipe and Spore, the only 100% accurate sleep-inducing move. Alright, let's roll! Fortunately, being quiet and not tempting fate works a lot better. Snubbull, the fairy Pokemon. Although it looks frightening, it is actually kind and affectionate. It is very popular among women. So there we are, we have Snubbull, and I'm going to see you back in Mahogany Town. Here we are, back again. If you want to buy things in Mahogany Town, you will have to go to this shop nearby. It's a little off. You'll notice that these items aren't very helpful, and they're selling Slowpoke tails as well. I wonder where we've seen that before. And this guy is blabbing about some sort of experiment. What is going on at the Lake of Rage? Let's heal our team and head up that way. I'm pretty sure you all know what's going on, if I'm going to be honest. You know the red Gyarados is up there. So, we can make our way along the path to the Lake of Rage. Worth noting, you can go through that gatehouse, but you will be charged money each time. I think it's 1,000 poker dollars. You can also cut through the long grass nearby. And we have an opponent for Torture to battle. He's at the front of the party, he's ready to go. Let's do it! There is a lot you can do with Pokemon. Spencer has Sandshrew. Not going to be particularly strong, unfortunately. We should be able to take care of it with Ember. There we go. This is admittedly pretty easy. Sand Slash, huh? It's a good Pokemon. I like it, but it does sort of suffer from the fact that it doesn't have access to good ground-type moves for a long time. Donphan also fares a bit better. It has slightly higher attack, and it has better HP. I think slightly higher defense as well. And the requisite Zubat. You had a great team going, buddy, and then you just ruined it. But even though we're facing weaker opponents, we're getting close. We are nearly, nearly there. Once I get Flame Wheel, that's not gonna happen. Basically, how the battle with Zubat goes. You have to hit yourself at least once in confusion, it seems like. And paltry experience. So, on we go into the long grass. There are some interesting new Pokemon to find, including one you can find at night. That is Noctowl. Will I find the Pokemon I'm interested in? Not before battling a trainer. I believe she has Clefairy. Or she does in the remake, anyway. Yep, Picnic at Tiffany and her Clefairy. We are nearly there. Thankfully, this will be a good moment for Torchic to shine. Alright. Just keep it up with Ember. Oh, close. And Encore, forcing us to use the same move over and over. Usually not very helpful. Lethal in the hands of Wobbuffet. Oh, close. Clefable is a pretty decent Pokemon. I can recommend using it. Well, we've run into Flaffy, which I do actually need to catch. Let's see, Quick Attack. If it uses Growl, I can use another one. Let's see if I can catch it, but I am trying to spare my Great Balls. Okay, that worked better than I thought. Flaffy, the wool Pokemon. As a result of storing too much electricity, it developed patches where even downy wool won't grow. So, sneak past this guy if I can. And there is an item we can grab. Max Aether, not too bad. We can branch off across that lake if we want to go hunting for items. I am going to see if I can find the Pokemon I've been talking about. Well, I found Pidgeotto. You know what this is like. Okay. Let's see how we go with this. If it starts to be too much trouble, I will leave it be. Nope, apparently having pretty good luck today. Pidgeotto, the bird Pokemon. It has outstanding vision. However high it flies, it is able to distinguish the movements of its prey. So I'll top up Torch's health and then I will quickly cut to the Pokemon I'm trying to find. Something special I want to show off as the spotlight for today. So, quick recovery. And away we go. See you when I find it. Here we go. This is the Pokemon I wanted to put in the spotlight for today. Meet Girafarig. Quite a lot is distinct about Girafarig, such as its push-me-pull-you inspired appearance and its normal psychic typing, which only two other Pokemon share. This actually gives Girafarig a bit of versatility, enabling it to confront a wide range of foes. Its attacking stats are fairly well balanced, if not remarkable, allowing it to use a pretty good variety of moves. Unfortunately, it's a little bit fragile, and on top of that, it tends to be found in out-of-the-way locations, such as Route 43 here, the Hoenn Safari Zone, and Route 214 and the Valor Lakefront in Sinnoh. This means it can often be overlooked for other psychic Pokemon, especially Alakazam, and you know I'm biased towards that. However, like a lot of Johto Pokemon, trying out Girafarig can yield some good results. That versatility is a major advantage a lot of other psychic types don't always have. It's a great counter to ghost types and can throw fighting types for a loop along the way. If you do run across Girafarig, it can be worth trying it out if you haven't already found a solid normal or psychic type Pokemon. And as always, let's try and catch it. Okay. You will note that Torchic is level 31. You will note he has Flame Wheel at long last. Let's switch to Sunny for now. I should be able to go pretty well with Confusion. Alright, we're in a good spot. Let's go with Hypnosis. And we're doing pretty well with that. And there we are, another one wrapped up very nicely. Girafarig, the long neck Pokemon. Its tail has a small brain of its own. Beware, if you get close, it may react to your scent and bite. So, I think that wraps up our adventuring pretty well today. We've got plenty done, we've caught some good Pokemon, we're ready to head up to the Lake of Rage, and our team is advancing pretty well. I will get to trading them soon enough. Thank you very much for joining me, and I will see you in the next installment of our scenic tour through the Johto region.